Hi everyone, in this video I'm very excited to talk about Quillbot. Quillbot is a web tool that I've recently discovered and I think it is amazing. Therefore, I want to share it with you. And if you've already used it before, I hope you will still learn something from this video. Quillbot allows us to paraphrase some text, and we can also use it to check the grammar of our text, to summarize the text, and to generate citations. Let's start with the paraphraser, which I think is amazing. So let me grab some text from a paper that I wrote. We're going to copy the abstract. So we select the abstract, press Ctrl-C, and then we can go back to Quillbot and we can paste the abstract. The first thing that we will notice is that if you have a free account, like me, you can only paraphrase 700 characters at a time. So let me delete this part here, but we're going to paraphrase it later. However, of course, you can buy a premium account, which is going to change the limits, so we can paraphrase more characters, we can summarize more a longer text, and so forth. So we can delete that section there, we can click on paraphrase, and Quillbot is paraphrasing the text for us. While it's paraphrasing, I just would like to tell you that I'm not sponsored by Quillbot. I honestly love this tool, and I think it's fantastic. Therefore, I want to talk about it and show you how to use it. Now Quillbot has paraphrased the text for us. There are a few things that we can change. We can change from mode, from standard to fluency. I'm limited only to standard and fluency, so I can click on fluency. It's going to re-paraphrase our text and it's going to generate a slightly different text from standard. The standard mode focuses more on a middle ground of changing the im and keeping the meaning, while fluency improves fluency and fixes grammatical mistakes of your text. Of course, you can also access creativity, formal, shorten, and expand if you have premium. Also, here we can change how many synonyms we want to use. So we can change the text more, but then it's going to be a little bit less accurate. One thing why Quillbot is great is because if I copy this text here as it is, and I go into Grammarly and I check for plagiarism, don't worry about the links. I will put the links down in the video description to Grammarly checker and to Quillbot. So if I copy this text here and I scan for plagiarism, you will see that we get an exclamation mark here. So it says significant plagiarism found. Let's go back here. Let's delete this text here and let's go back to Quillbot. And now copy this text here, so Ctrl-C, we can go back to Grammarly, we can paste it, scan for plagiarism, and that's it. We're good to go. So we can use it in our paper, in our text, if you want to share a post online, and so forth. Quillbot, as you've seen, works very well with scientific paper, but also works equally well with articles from news. So let me grab, here some text from The Guardian. Just a random article, so Ctrl-Copy, I can go back to Quillbot, I can Ctrl-A, Ctrl-V, I can click on paraphrase, and this is going to paraphrase the text for us. And honestly, I think the results are fantastic, then we don't have to worry about plagiarism. And here we can see that the orange are the change word, the yellow are the structural changes, while in black we can see the part of the text that Quillbot has not changed. So for instance, here in Glasgow in November, this part of the text was not changed by Quillbot. Another very nice thing is the grammar checker, which we can test the grammar of our text. So we can just copy and paste. Most likely this text will be fine because we just grab it from The Guardian. Of course, if you write some text, you might have some typos in it. So you can also check for the grammar. And finally, another thing that is great, I think, is the summarizer. So here we can paste a longer text. So let me grab a little bit more text here, again, from that Guardian article. Let's go back to Quillbot. We can paste the text. And then we can choose how to summarize it. We can have some key sentences or a paragraph. Let's also click here on the keywords that we want to select. So we want climate, we want emission, and let's say that we want to click on nations. I will show you later better with my abstract. So I can click on summarize, and this is the text that Quillbot has generated for us. We can also create key sentences. So Quillbot is summarizing the text for us in key sentences. And we can select to have fewer sentences or more bullet points. It's up to you to choose. Again, let me show you with a scientific article because that might slightly change. So I'm going to grab this abstract, go back to Quillbot, I'm going to Ctrl-A, Ctrl-Paste, and then I can click on Summarize. Here it's going to divide my text in bullet points, and I think they are very well written, but also I can have a paragraph. In this case, I just have to select what I want to keep. So I want to focus on thermal and comfort. I want to focus on PyThermal Comfort because it's the name of my Python package. And let's say I want to click on standard. So I can click on summarize, and Quillbot, based on my selection, is going to create a paragraph that is going to maintain these keywords. And here we can see what it has used and which part of the text it has used and which part actually were not carried forward in the paragraph. The final thing that I want to show you is the citation generator. So here I can paste the URL of my article and then I can press on cite. I just have to put in some key information such as author, last name. In this case, there are two authors, but then we have website title. So let's just put my name, even though it's not complete because I did not write that paper alone. You can just put the name of the surname of the authors and then you can click on save citation. And here has generated a citation that we can copy if we want to cite this website. So full citation, here is the citation. Finally, one other great thing is that you can add extension to Microsoft Word, Google Chrome, and Google Docs. I really think Quillbot is a fantastic tool, and I'm sure you will also use it and you will find it very useful. If you like this video, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. Also, if you like this type of content, please do not forget to press on the bell icon so you're going to be notified when I release new videos. If you want to support this channel, you can do so by buying me a coffee or supporting me on Patreon. More information down in the video description below, or you can join my channel here on YouTube. Thank you very much for listening and see you in the next video.